Use the Force, Luke.
Live long and prosper.
I was going into Tosche Station to pick up some power converters.
Lilu Dallas Multipass.
Shut up and take my money.
By Grabthar's hammer. What a saving.
One does not simply walk into Mordor.
X never, ever marks the spot.
Winter is coming.
You're a wizard, Harry.
Stay a while and listen.
My whole Kermit the Frog.
Your ties are cool.
So say we all.
This is a Play on Nerds.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's been a long time coming, but welcome back to episode 45 of A Play on Nerds. As always, I'm Steve.
And I'm Jarman, the lovely co-host.
Making yourself sound like Vanna White over there.
I'm waving at letters right now.
They're all glow, so I know which one to touch.
Ding!
We've been off for a little bit, but it's because we've had things going on. In this case, nerdy things. And yes. Later on, Jarman is going to be talking about all about his trip to DragonCon.
DragonCon. So what have you been up to then? If I've been at DragonCon and doing other things, what have you been doing?
Well, here, I've been... The big thing that took all my time was surviving a terrible heat wave that came through my area of California. It was so lovely. Like a week and a half ago, highs in the 80s, nice and cool at night with a breeze. And then out of nowhere, it's like, oh yeah, and on Monday, it's going to be 102 degrees.
Jeez.
So we had a week straight of high 90s, low 100s. That was just unbearable and just sapped the energy out of my life. And made us discover new sad ways to keep cool, including we took a empty jug of kitty litter and we filled it with water and froze it and then put that in front of our fan.
Yeah, this is something
that's how desperate we were.
So confused me about when you moved to California, because us here in the Southeast all have air conditioners and you don't have an air conditioner in your house, which is so strange.
No, because we're sort of in the cool area of California and it doesn't get too hot here. But every now and then we get a week of just awfulness.
I think everyone on Earth should have a heater and an air conditioner. It's just a matter of fact.
Human rights, people. Human rights.
Basic human rights. It's been that hot over here all the time, basically. So muggy and disgusting.
Well, that's the difference. You guys have humidity that we don't even.
True.
We can't even begin to approach out here. People here are like, it's so humid. I'm like, shut up. Shut up.
I walked from my inside the house, took the trash out, came back in. I was covered in sweat.
Just drenched. It's like you're walking through a bowl of butter every time you go outside. It's just terrible.
Ugh.
So you've been to DragonCon. What else has been up?
Well, I've moved into the official Southeast headquarters of A Play on Nerds. We're in a brand new studio right now. So if my recording suddenly cuts out, it's because not everything is hooked up properly yet. But finally recording out of here, and we'll eventually have streaming out of here too once I get the internet up to par. Because we tried streaming with Glitzy Gamers last week on our Twitch channel. And if, for those of you who don't know, it's where we have two lovely young ladies who love to stream games out of the A Play on Nerds studio. But our upload speed was so slow that we couldn't even stream. So we just recorded it. We might put it on YouTube later, but no one could watch it.
Okay.
But
get that Comcast upgrade.
Pretty much. It's going to cost me like $75 more a month. But hey, it's worth it.
Does Roadrunner still exist down there? Is that still a thing?
I think Roadrunner got absorbed by Comcast or Bright House or something.
When I was living in Florida a decade ago, that was the peak and pinnacle of internet.
Yeah. That was like the first cable internet available over here.
Oh, my God. I remember begging my parents so I could play Team Fortress Classic to get cable internet.
And so my stepbrother could play Quake and get into the tournaments and stuff.
Damn right. And it was worth it, parents.
So worth it. So you don't have to use a phone line anymore. See, that makes it worth it right there.
That's true, because who has a phone line anymore?
Exactly.
I love how they try to bundle phone lines in with things now.
Yeah, it's like please take them, please.
For this flat rate, you get TV service, cable internet, a Wi-Fi router, and then we'll throw in a landline for you.
It's like, sorry, actually, all I need of those three things is internet. I get it on all three.
Can I unclick the box for phone or no?
No, it just comes with it. Okay. Just take it. You got it.
Now, if it came with one of those classic like Mickey Mouse phones.
Oh, yeah.
Or one of the ones that's a burger, then I would sign up.
Or the see-through phone that's been like was like Clueless and stuff.
Oh my God. That was the hotness.
I think my sister had all of those phones.
She did. And she had multiple lava lamps.
Yes.
It's time for Nerdy News.
Well, a lot of stuff has happened in nerdy news over the past couple of weeks that we've been gone.
Yeah, there's been a lot of craziness going on.
Good news first from you?
Good news first? Sure. I don't have any good news.
Oh, if you don't, that's fine. Neither do I. So we'll just go a string of bad nerdy news.
It's all negative nerds. Well, not really. So the one thing I want to talk about is something that we don't really ever talk about is the tech industry.
Mm.
And Apple had a huge event, huge announcement. Like a 2.5 hour thing.
I know that company.
And they announced some new products, and some of them are kind of exciting. We have the iPad Pro, which is just a huge iPad. Just huge.
You're just carrying around a monitor in your hands, basically.
Oh my God! Yes, it's the screen of the laptop you're looking at right now. That's the iPad Pro. And as someone who has had the luxury of seeing it in person, the demos that they didn't do it justice to how big it is.
So what makes it pro? Just because it's giant, so professional.
It's got a heavier duty chip, the A9X, which is the highest performing chip that Apple has ever put in an iOS device. Some cool new display technology that's going to allow it to be a little bit more precise, which is really what the aim of this device is for. And what most of the demos that Apple showed was for is that the complaint with the iPad is that, yeah, it's great for my dad to check his email. And for somebody who wants to take, you know, presentations, that sort.
Some on PowerPoints. The go with them.
But the professionals that want to use it have complained that it isn't powerful enough to run the tools that they want to be able to run.
Mm.
And that's the reason that the demos came from Microsoft, of all people, showing Microsoft Office working seamlessly on it. And then Adobe pulled out and showed a bunch of their new creative tools and how they integrate on it. And that it's powerful enough to do those.
I actually have the whole Adobe Creative Cloud, and I just downloaded a bunch of their apps for my iPad mini. The problem is it doesn't have the power to run a lot of that, so I can run like the lighter side ones. But it's really cool how Adobe has all those products now for iPad.
Yeah, and so it's really their shot back at, well, it can do these things now, so go do them. And then that also led to the Apple Pencil.
Which they were saying was bad because apparently Steve Jobs says he would never have a stylus for his products. That was like a thing he said before he died or something.
So yeah, with the release of the iPhone, he said, you know, and everyone's asking us about a stylus for this device. And he goes, well, you know what? We don't need a stylus because every single person in America owns 10 styluses. And then he held up his fingers. And he really wanted that. But the fact of the matter is that Apple is trying to market these tools to higher end professionals that have higher end needs. And fingers aren't going to cut it for doing things like complex AutoCAD drawings.
True. It's and less precise.
The type of rendering and graphic stuff that Apple is trying to push the iPad Pro for.
And even something simple like where I'm at a show and I have people like swiping with the swipe thing off my iPad and they have to sign their name with their finger. It's unprofessional and that's not really their signature either. So having a stylus would be nice.
Yeah. And the cool things about how it can read the angle that you're holding it to the display, and then it calibrates the writing tool you're choosing to work with. So if you're working with a calligraphy pen app, it'll actually tell it the angle that you're hitting the display at and adjust accordingly. The new display measures micro pressure stuff that allows you to push harder or lighter to get a finer line or a more distinct line. So I think that is really why the pencil has become a necessity because of the way that Apple is trying to market this device.
They really should be sponsoring our podcast.
They should be. The other big one is the new phones, you know, bigger, stronger, faster as always. But the real stealer of the show is 3D touch.
What the hell does that mean?
Which I personally think is a really goofy name. But effectively from what I can see on the demos, it's the right click on your mouse for an iOS device.
Okay.
For a long time, you only had the single click. You had to open things up and go into options, and then they developed the right click to bring up more options without having to necessarily go all the way into a program. And that's what I think this 3D touch is going to effectively work as.
Whereas before, most tablets, you'd have to just hold down your finger to have that same effect.
Right. So now they've made it so that if you 3D touch on your phone app, it'll bring up an option to take a selfie without you having to go into the phone app. those sort of things.
That's the important thing. How fast can I take a selfie?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it really is. And they did some other cool selfie technology where now the display will flash like the flash of a camera when you're taking a selfie, so you can still have good lighting when you're taking selfies.
Ooh.
These are the important things. So Apple has released some very cool things this week. I'll be interested to see how they pan out and if they, as always, Apple promises to revolutionize the tech world, and I'm always interested to see if they actually do it.
They have before, and they'll do it again.
Yeah, they probably will. What news do you bring us?
My sad news that if you're a podcast listener in general, I'm sure every other podcast has already mentioned this, but it's quite a sad thing indeed, is that Wes Craven, the wonderful horror director, has passed away on Sunday, August 30th. He was only 76 years old, and he suffered from brain cancer for a while there, apparently, and that wasn't very well publicized to my knowledge, but he did sadly pass away. Just a few things about him: that his first feature film was Last House on the Left, which did very well, being his first film. And of course, he's known for the Nightmare on Elm Street series, which was the start of Johnny Depp's career and that kind of thing. And then moved on.
Yeah. Also, The Hills Have Eyes, which is classic.
That's a good one.
Just classic horror.
And then the Scream series, which everyone loved from the 90s onward, which is just, it really flipped the genre.
Which he directed all of them.
Yeah. Did he direct all of them or just some of them? I don't know.
I think he directed all of them.
Wow. But it was just,
I like to see what the internet says.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes, he directed all of them.
There you go. But he was just good at making like fun horror movies. I think he's the first guy to do that where it's like, yeah, they were legitimately scary at times, but they're also just fun to watch. And they weren't like way too dark to make it where it's just like, I don't know, like a, what's that guy? Not Marilyn Manson. The guy who does horror movies. Rob Zombie. Like nothing like that where it's like.
Rob Zombie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But and a weird, a little random happy fact about him. He was from Cleveland, Ohio, and apparently he was a committed bird conservationist. And he served as a longtime member on the Audubon, California Board of Directors, which is kind of cool.
Oh, okay.
That's what he did during his non-horror times.
Yeah, horror's lost a lot of big people this year. Christopher Lee and then now Wes Craven. Who's next?
I don't want to guess. I'm scared. But yeah, actually, I think at DragonCon, they did a panel on Wes Craven and Christopher Lee. So, the two big guys in horror.
So now some fun kind of movie news. Sort of fun. A little bit sad. So there are some new sequels that are coming out and that have been confirmed from studios. And some of them are cool and some of them make me very sad. Jeepers Creepers is getting a third movie.
Oh, good.
Fun fact, Mr. Salva, who wrote and directed the first two, is back to write and direct this one. He's a convicted pedophile. So that's exciting.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah, in like his second big film that actually had a budget, he got oral sex from someone under the age of 14. So that's exciting.
He's
back. So I'm glad that they gave him, the Hollywood gave him a second chance.
Don't see that movie, folks.
New Pirates of the Caribbean film, Dead Men Tell No Tales. Early reviews from people in the cast say that it's much like more like the original film. So that's positive because the most recent ones were just nightmarish atrocities.
They're all mixing together for me now.
And they have confirmed that they are going to do a joint Godzilla and King Kong film.
Now, was that totally confirmed or still just kind of rumored? Because I thought that was still rumor stage.
Last I heard, it was confirmed because the studio bought the rights back.
Yeah.
Warner Brothers bought the rights back from,
I think it was Universal.
Yeah, that sounds right. Which I don't know how they're going to do, because in this last movie, they made Godzilla huge.
Yeah, I mean,
giant huge.
I saw a video on that from the Nerdist talking about that. Just like, he'd be like, you need like 13 King Kongs in a trench coat to stand up against the Godzilla they made. Because he's huge.
So that's why they take King Kong. They combine it with Power Rangers and they like zord together to make a mecha,
exactly,
mega King Kong.
They also were saying
that
like
fights Godzilla. Maybe now that's the movie I want
to
see.
Maybe the King Kong on Skull Island was a baby and now he'll grow to full height to be as big as King Kong or as big as Godzilla. But I don't know. It's going to be weird.
I don't think that's nah. There's also talks, at least from Del Toro, that Godzilla is going to be featured in the third Pacific Rim film.
That would be fun.
That they will be in the same universe
somehow. Because like,
yeah, I don't know. How he can do whatever he wants. I trust him.
Or yeah, weren't the monsters from Pacific Rim like in another dimension or something? Because in theory, that would mean that they could just Godzilla could hop to this dimension and then be in the same universe as the Pacific Rim people. I don't know. They'll figure out a way to
do it. You know, or aliens or something. It doesn't matter.
Just mash them all together.
Yeah, just make them, just take all the things you like and now kiss. And push them all together.
Make out.
So three sequels, one of which I'm kind of excited for, and the other one's, I don't know.
They'll be a thing.
Yeah, people will go see them. They'll make millions and millions of dollars. But so did Hitler. So
it's true. And he shot himself in the face.
Take a moment to reflect on that. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I want to launch us into our big Comic-Con discussion by playing a game that I've put together called Comic-Con Bingo. So when I went to New York Comic-Con, I saw the same like six costumes over and over and over again.
Yep.
And I have put together a card, much like a bingo card, five down and five across, of costumes that I would expect Jarman to have seen at Comic-Con. And I want to go through them, and if Jarman actually saw them, I'm going to cross them off and see if I can make bingo on my scorecard.
I think this will work.
I think it will. All right, so I put some very, very obvious ones on here, because I know that you will have seen these people, and maybe a few less obvious ones. All right, Deadpool.
Yes, of course. So many Deadpools. Less than last year, but still a lot.
Harley Quinn.
So many Harley Quinns, just as many as last year.
There's always, always just as many as last year. Batman.
Yes, several Batmans. A lot of them probably shouldn't have been Batman, but, you know, props to them for having confidence.
Captain America.
Yep, I saw male, female, everything Captain America.
Haha, I've got female Captain America on my card, too.
Oh, there Perfect. You go. You can cross that off.
Hawkeye.
Yes, I actually talked to a Hawkeye while I was there. Yep.
Okay. Wolverine.
Oh, yeah. Lots of Wolverines. Lots of old man Logans, too. So that was cool.
Okay. Superman.
Yes.
Chewbacca.
I almost ran straight into a Chewbacca coming out of an elevator, actually. It was really scary.
I'm just imagining Chewbacca just really having to go to the bathroom.
Like, I really don't know.
Angry Chewbacca waiting outside of a bathroom.
I don't know if he was like a guy who was actually 7'4" or if he was like in some kind of weird stilts or something, but he was like huge. So it was like life size.
Well, when you're that tall, you have limited choices as far as what it's like either Chewbacca or Groot. And those are your options.
That's true.
So The Flash.
Oh, I got to think about that one. I must have, but I don't,
figured with the popularity of the TV show.
Yeah, like I must have seen it, but I don't remember seeing one.
All right. The Flash didn't make the cut. Okay.
Surprisingly.
That is the first one so far that did not make the cut.
Yeah.
The Joker.
Yes. I saw many good Jokers too, surprisingly.
Captain Jack Sparrow.
Oh God, there was an awful one. Yeah, he like came walking by me. And he's like in character while walking around. So he has like one hand up in the air, pretending to be drunk, and well, he might have actually been drunk, but it was kind of awkward.
Stormtroopers?
Yes, I got lots of awesome Stormtrooper footage. Actually, you'll see later on the channel. But we even had one Daft Punk Stormtrooper. It was fantastic.
All four Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
I don't remember seeing all four at one time, but I did see one guy in like prosthetic turtle makeup, and I did see a fantastic April O'Neil, but I guess that doesn't count.
I'm going to say no, because the qualifier was all four.
Yeah.
Bob from Bob's Burgers.
Yes. I took a whole picture with the whole group of them, actually, that did the whole cast of Bob's Burgers.
Like a gang of them?
Yeah. They're my buddies, Joel's
Jedi.
Friends. Yes.
Okay.
Did a lot of a video of guys doing like full Jedi garb doing lightsaber battles.
Power Rangers.
Yes. So a lot of Power Rangers. I can't believe how many of these I see.
Legolas.
I don't think there was. I mean, there probably was one there, but I didn't see a Legolas directly.
No, I only what you actually saw.
Yeah, I didn't see one directly.
All right. Spider-Man's parents.
These are getting a little more obscure, I guess. No, I did not see Spider-Man's parents.
Well, I just saw a picture of somebody go as Spider-Man's parents.
That's a good idea.
And it was very obscure. All right. Doctor Who.
Absolutely. Every kind of iteration you could think of.
Mike Myers.
Like from Halloween?
Yes.
Yes, there is actually a great one. And there's a rumor that some celebrity, I can't remember who it is now, but always goes around as Mike Myers at the conventions. And we saw him going around. So it's fun. He was really scary.
Huh. Homer Simpson.
I saw him last year, but not this year. Nope.
Okay. No Homer.
It's always creepy when they go as Homer Simpson because the weird yellow makeup and everything. It's weird.
Yeah, that just makes them look like they've got jaundice.
Yeah, exactly.
Captain Picard. Jean-Luc.
Don't think I saw Picard. I saw a great Riker. We got an interview with one, but
okay.
No Picard.
Ooh, no Picard. Poison Ivy.
I do not recall seeing a Poison Ivy.
And finally, Catwoman.
Yes. Saw lots of different kinds of Catwoman. And the best one I saw was a girl probably about 14, 15 years old going as the one from Gotham. And she had the costume down to a T and she had like a great pose and everything. We got a picture of her too. So it was awesome.
Okay. So out of all the ones I named, there were only six. No, there were seven that you didn't see. And I got three complete bingos on my sheet.
Three bingos.
Three complete bingos. That's how many of these characters I could accurately predict.
I'm telling
would be
you,
there.
Man, DragonCon is like the number one for convention for costuming, and especially so. It's where you're gonna see all of these.
Even more than San Diego.
Oh yeah, that even the celebrities say that because there's more people going to San Diego Comic Con just to go who aren't like cosplaying. Because there's so many movies that are there and stuff.
Right.
But for DragonCon, it's like all fan based, so it's like it's mainly cosplayers or people just going in dopey costumes for the hell of it. So I've heard a lot of celebrities say that.
Fair enough. Okay. Well, cool. So that should get everybody in the DragonCon mind.
Absolutely. Set,
as German leads us into our discussion of what the hell happened there.
Well, this is the first time I went to DragonCon with our buddy Patrick, who is our video game correspondent, our guy who heads up Twitch for A Play on Nerds. And luckily, he lives in Tallahassee. I live in Orlando, Florida. So we were able to drive up together to Atlanta to go to DragonCon. And we go every year. This is the first year we brought up our video equipment and our sound stuff. We had a Play on Nerds t-shirts and we were able to go around doing interviews and taking pictures on behalf of a Play on Nerds. So it was a learning experience. We did not do it perfectly. We'll know better what to ask next year and what the things we'll need to get better footage of for next year. And especially by the time it's the fourth day when you've gotten no sleep and you've been, you know, possibly drinking for some of that time, you're not giving the best interviews.
Nah.
But we had a good time. And I think people we interviewed had a good time as well. But I saw a few panels while I was there. I watched the show Defiance on the Sci-Fi channel. So almost the whole cast of Defiance was there. So that was a lot of fun. Went to a Star Wars panel, which had Chewbacca himself, Peter Mayhew, there, which was awesome. It was awesome seeing him, but it was kind of sad because he recently had a lot of health problems that have caused him to be very run down, and it's hard to even understand his speech very well because he can barely walk and talk. Yeah, he can't speak very well.
Anyone that height and size, it just comes with health problems.
Absolutely. And then it was mainly like it started with his knees, and he had his knees replaced. And while he was in the hospital for that, he got like pneumonia and all these other problems. But the weird thing was, if you might have seen this out there, nerds, there's this new toy that's becoming very popular. It's the B-88 toy from the new Star Wars movie.
Oh, yeah. Little roller guy.
Exactly. And they have one that's really tiny and you control it with your smartphone. You can roll it around remotely. And they're not selling very many of them yet, but they're going to release them to the general public fairly soon if they haven't already. And they're $150. So they are showing them for the first time at conventions, and they showed it at DragonCon. And because I went to Felicia Day panel, and she was talking about how she really wanted one and she didn't have one. So we go to a rave later that night to get footage of the big dance party happening that goes till 5:30 in the morning. And this one guy's dancing around while wheeling around a B-88 toy. And we're like, wow, he has one of them. So we went over and asked him, hey, can we film some of you with B-88 for our website at Play on Nerds? And he says, sure, no problem. So we film it a little bit and we get to talking to him. And it turns out he's Peter Mayhew's personal assistant. So he's Chewbacca's personal assistant. And that's, wow, that's how he had early access to the toy. And he told us about how he has to take, you know, Peter Mayhew to, you know, his physical therapy every day and drives him to all the different conventions and stuff. And it's a lot of fun to do. But so, yeah, you'll see video later on of a little B-88 rolling around. He's adorable.
Very nice.
And a lot of the other time we played lots of games, board games with people, just people watched and talked to people. It's just a great place to meet other fellow nerds. And I listened to the Rusted Robot podcast, and they are really pushing a new convention in their area because they're in northeastern Canada. So they're trying to get a small convention together in northeastern Canada that's getting bigger and bigger. And it's just kind of cool to think about how DragonCon once started off that small, and now it's gigantic. It's the biggest convention in the eastern United States. So eventually you'll get there, Canada. but no, Canada has some huge conventions, like Toronto has real big ones too, and Montreal.
So who was the celebrity you were most excited about seeing while you were there?
I don't know. I didn't get to see a couple of celebrities I wanted to see because just timing didn't work out. Like Karen Gillan was there. She was Nova in Guardians of the Galaxy. And you know what I'm talking about?
Okay.
You saw Guardians of the Galaxy, right?
Yeah.
the blue lady, so the son, the daughter of Thanos. And she was, yeah. But she's also a companion in Doctor Who. So that's why I really like her because she's Scottish and
I didn't realize
adorable.
That.
She usually has long red hair, but anyways, I couldn't see her at a panel.
So I recognize her now.
Yeah, she's pretty cool.
Were there any celebrities that you saw and you were like, oh, there's that guy?
That usually happens. But I didn't even get to the Walk of Fame, which is kind of a cool thing to do where you get to go to the Walk of Fame and just see all the people that are giving autographs and not pay for an autograph, but just, you know, people watch and stare at them awkwardly. But like I went to saw Patrick Stewart that way. He was there with his son who looks just like him. I was like, I'm now in the same area as Patrick Stewart. And it's funny because after I did that, the rest of the robot people did the same thing. They're like, we're breathing the same air as Patrick Stewart. It's fun to think of that. But and I really want to go to a fan panel. They have a lot of these at DragonCon where they just have a bunch of expert fans on a subject, run a panel, and everyone there just kind of ask questions. And they lead discussions and talk about stuff. And I didn't get to do that either because we were filming and partying too much. It's really nerd Mardi Gras is what it is.
You damn party animals.
And I want you to come next year. Somehow.
Maybe. Yeah.
Better get together, boy. So what I was going to do is play a couple of the interviews we got. We can stop them throughout and talk about it. But just forgive me because I sound like a doofus on these interviews because I'm trying to yell really loudly so they can hear me. And I also had not perfected my interview skills yet. And I'm going to practice that. But we had some very nice people, some people very drunk. This particular gentleman you're about to hear is dressed as Barf from Spaceballs, but it's the undead version of Barf. So it's interesting. And he's very intoxicated.
Sweet.
You ready? Okay. So, what is your name?
Bartholomew.
Bartholomew. All right. So, what is the most embarrassing moment you've had at a convention, either that you witnessed or that you were a part of?
A girl grabbed my tail and said, "I want some tail."
Did you get some tail after
that? Oh, I got some tail that night. That's for sure.
All right. What is the worst and best things about DragonCon? If you had to name
the people
anything.
And the people.
They're both
so
the same
many
time.
Yeah, both. It's both. Is it both?
What makes the
so
best people?
So many people. It's so fun. You get drunk with a lot of random people who love the same stuff as you. But then there are a lot of really drunk people around, like myself.
Like yourself, Bartholomew.
Yes.
So you're undead Bart.
I am undead Bart.
That's perfect. Let's see.
I should be on Walking Dead, just like as a cameo in the background.
What's that? You go to panels here, right, at DragonCon?
I've been to a few.
What's the worst thing a douchebag can do at a panel to make the panel, like, everyone groan?
Argue with the panel.
Argue with the panel?
Yeah.
Like the celebrities?
Yeah.
What's the, like, have you had an example of that happen before?
I was at a panel called Dragon Sex.
I saw that one on the program.
I was at it last year, and this guy was arguing about a character, and it's really complicated. There's a lot of dragon sex involved in this book that they're talking about.
Yeah.
But
he argued with the panel.
Yeah, he argued with the lady who was presenting it, and the son of the author.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Was it the Pern thing?
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
We can cut some of this out later.
Dragon Riders of Pern?
Yeah, Dragon Riders of Pern. Yeah. They had a whole track for that. They still do, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it has a huge following. It's actually a really good book.
I still haven't read it.
So wait. Are you telling me there are books about dragon sex?
Yeah, apparently it's called The Dragon Riders of Pern, and it's a very popular book series that I'd never heard of until I got to DragonCon. And this has a huge following. It's a thing. But the author...
I got to get on that ride.
The author, M. McCafferty, just passed away not long ago. So I think the track is kind of going to be gone soon. But anyways.
As long as there's enough dragon sex to hold me over until someone else picks up the mantle.
Well, there's sex around dragons in Game of Thrones.
Sort of. A little bit. Nah, not really.
All right, let's hear what else.
That's what George R.R. needs in the next novel is more dragon sex.
Like actual dragon on dragon sex.
I mean, or you could go biracial or cross-racial dragon sex and humans and dragons and...
How to Train Your Dragon 3, dragon sex.
Oh, God, that would be a hell of a sequel.
Oh, dearie, I love having sex with a dragon.
That's awful.
Take care of it, DreamWorks.
That's horrible.
All right, onward.
Next con. What or who, I guess.
Oh, like, God.
Someone or something you like to see the next con.
I'd like to see, like, some game panels. Other
game
than,
panels?
Like, bigger games.
Like board games or video games?
Video games.
So, like, have more of the people coming from the companies to talk about
Yeah,
them?
Like Bethesda or something like that.
He was just talking about Bethesda, yeah.
I am a huge Bethesda fan. I actually had... Bethesda Inc.
He's showing a tattoo on his leg.
Shot of that.
From
that is impressive. Is
Morrowind?
That the scrolls?
Yes. This is from Oblivion.
Yeah.
It's the entrance Oblivion. To the Shivering Isles. And then I've got a Skyrim dragon. I'll have another one on this side. And it'll all be set on a scene of the Imperial City.
Damn it. That's awesome. He was saying they don't have enough Bethesda presence here, so that's a good thing.
Well, they just started doing panels.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, in general?
Yeah.
Like
just
anywhere.
At this past E3.
Oh, wow.
That was our first time ever being at E3.
That makes more sense now.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, thank you, Bartholomew.
No problem.
That's Bartholomew. He was drunk.
He sounded a little drunk. just a smidge, though. Not a ton.
Just a tad. All right. So this is a guy who approached us in a hallway. He was a dad with his two daughters.
He approached you.
Yeah, because we were just hanging out, trying to get into a panel, but we had all our equipment with us. He's like, "Hey, you guys doing interviews?" So he was a very fun guy. So, and his daughters were, I think they were both his daughters, but they're both very nice. So
you hope they were both his daughters.
It'd be a little weird if they weren't. But one of them was a bit older.
Interview my concubines.
One of them could have been his younger girlfriend. I'm not sure, but I'm thinking it's both his daughters. So I didn't really ask. So here we go.
All right, and is this your first time at DragonCon, or have you been here before?
I've been here many, many times. Absolutely love it. As far as cons go, greatest parties. You can walk around, just drink. as much as you want, as long as you want. No one will question you. You can come up to a guy that has a camera and a mic and all of a sudden just come over here and just talk and just say whatever it is you want to say.
What makes it the best con is that it's so casual, like it's fan friendly?
Oh, absolutely.
At any point, you can just walk up to someone and say, hey, can I have a drink of what you drinking? And it's a welcomed offer, generally.
What does your hat say right now?
Huh? If you don't roll coal, you can kiss my gas. Squidbillies. Thank you, Adult
Squidbillies
Swim.
Squidbillies is great, yeah. Where are you guys from?
Savannah.
I love Savannah. It's beautiful. Oh, great. It's wonderful.
But yeah, man, just run up here. Like I say, you know, this is the con where you can just kind of be yourself, do whatever the hell you want to do. There are tracks for every possible fandom out there. Even Filking, which is terrible, but you know, if you
like,
Wait, stop. What?
Do you know what Filking is?
What is this?
I didn't know what it was until DragonCon either, but apparently it's just people who sit around in a circle and they have drums and some guitars or ukuleles sometimes, and they sing folk style songs about like nerdy and fancy stuff. And they just kind of riff for hours on end. Some people make fun of it, like they're call them all hippies, and they sit there for so many hours they don't shower, and this drum circle starts to smell. And
the genre has been active since the early 1950s.
Wow!
Holy crap!
Interesting. I didn't know that long.
Yeah. Shit.
So yeah, there's a whole Filking track at DragonCon, and they basically have their one room where they just sit there and party, and I don't know. Jam it out to guitars and drum circles.
So what you're telling me is that at Dragon Con, those are the guys that have weed.
Probably.
Is what I'm hearing.
It's a good bet. Or at least a hemp necklace to sell you.
That's true.
All right, here we go.
Sorry, I had to stop you. No, I'd never heard of that
before. About to stop and ask if you knew what that was.
No.
Probably you like terrible things? Then you can go there and have cookies and listen to people sing horrible music.
Cookies?
That's exactly.
They have cookies.
They have cookies?
Yeah, Filking cookies.
So what are your fandoms of choice? We refer you first.
I guess a generalist, man. You know, gaming, you know, Star Wars, Star Trek, comics. I'm just a generalist.
Who's your captain of Star Trek?
That's a fallacy, man. You know, well,
they're all
it's
great.
Clearly not Janeway.
Oh, Janeway. Oh, she's great in Orange is the New Black. She's good now.
Yeah, but she doesn't sound like a robot now.
True.
She actually learned to act probably from doing that show.
That voice of hers is so... It is kind of weird.
And
like
then
that.
They decided to call her Sir for a while, and then we're going to call her Ma'am.
They did do that. That's right.
Yeah, they called her Sir, and then
they
we decided to go with Ma'am.
Sir. They called all women Sir in Star Trek.
For a while, and then they changed it.
And then a couple seasons into it, hey, you know... It's like the continuity. We're just going to call her Ma'am and just go with it because it's weird.
That is weird. I didn't think about that.
Yeah, but you know.
So what are your fandoms of choice?
Cartoons in general. Tomorrow I'll be Amethyst from Steven Universe.
Very cool.
Star Trek, other than that, gaming. This is my DM, actually.
Very cool.
So
not her dad.
I started a new gaming group the other week, so yeah, I'm happy about that.
How many years is our group? Like eight?
I didn't choose it.
10-year group? It's like a 10-year D&D group.
Oh, wow.
Long
maybe
going
for like
history.
5 years, yeah. So, okay, so what gaming do you do then? What's your game then?
Dungeons and Dragons and anything from Nintendo.
3.0, 5.0,
4.0. 2.0.
Ooh, even better. Damn. 2.0. Originalist. Okay, I'm sorry, I cursed in front of the young one. No. I'm sorry.
why buy new books?
Good job, Jeremy.
What?
That's why true. Buy new books?
That's true.
They still work.
What is your fandom of choice?
Gaming.
Video games or like board gaming kind of thing?
Both.
Both. That's even better. That's awesome.
D&D. I play.
Is this one yours?
Yes.
You started her young, so you're a Whovian.
Yes.
So you have seen the new Who? Do you like the new Doctor, or how do you feel about him?
He's good. I like Matt Smith.
Oh, Matt Smith's good.
It's my favorite.
So what is the most awkward thing or strange thing you've seen at a convention before? Like, what is that person doing kind of thing?
Probably having to explain what not a costume is, which would be the chicks walking around with, you know, stickers over their nipples.
Duct tape.
What is that?
Not a costume.
Not a costume.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, and the thing we, you know, always try to tell, like, you know, first conners is look for the Adam's apple.
Oh, yes.
That can be an awkward situation.
That's true.
Very awkward situation. But
more a pleasant one if you're looking for it.
True. If that's your thing, go for it. Yeah. You know, whatever.
not my deal, but hey, you know, filking isn't either, so.
Filking is a thing.
Whatevs.
Try everything once, at least one time, filking included.
Or kiss my gas.
Or kiss my gas.
That's a good one.
I think I would take the Adam's apple over filking.
I'm a little worried about filking. Unless they have really good cookies, then that might be okay.
True.
Anyway, I think that one was mostly done anyways. But we have several more. Here, I'll let you choose the last one we'll watch, okay? You have a choose.
Okay.
Okay, so we have a guy who went as one of the guys in all white from Mad Max Fury Road. I don't know if you saw that movie. We have a couple of Daredevil and Black Widow.
Okay.
We have a girl who went as one of the blue people from Avatar. And we have a Furiosa and a Mad Max. And we have...
Let's do Hot Blue Girl.
Hot Blue Girl. That's the one I sound like the most of a doofus, so just be aware.
Was it because she was a girl?
Well, she's a very attractive girl and a very revealing outfit.
You're wearing blue spandex.
And I'm pretty sure I'd had a few beers at that point in the night. And it was very loud, so I was trying to talk over people. So I sound like a big doofus. I laugh way too much. So please forgive me. That's going to be cut out when we put this on YouTube.
Did you ask her if you guys could intertwine your head braids? Is that
our ear penises or whatever the hell they call them?
Yes. I think that's the technical term.
Don't worry about that. It's a technical term. All right. Well, here it is. The awful interview. She was great. This is her first convention, but she had the most immaculate costume. You'll have to look on the YouTube channel, folks, later on when this comes out, and you'll see her like fantastic costume. So it's pretty awesome.
Good. Okay. So what's your name?
Actually,
if you want to say anything,
do you want me to be in character or are we just kind of...
You can be yourself. That's probably fine. You want to give your name?
Sure. My name is Meredith.
And who are you today?
Today I am Neytiri. The Amatikara clan, yes. Neytiri.
Neytiri, that's right. Okay.
From Pandora.
So this is your first DragonCon?
Yes, it is.
What has it been like for you so far?
It's just been... It's a dream come true. Like, it's nice to, like, see and find so many people that, like, I can identify with.
Exactly.
So
have you been to convention before this one?
I haven't. This is my first one in general.
How the heck are you so good at making costumes and such?
Well, I was in the Renaissance Fair for a couple years in Tennessee. Okay. And I've always kind of had a crafty side, and I just finally found a niche to, like, you know.
I'd say you're doing quite well.
Yeah,
it looks
thank
fantastic.
You. Thank you.
So what's the strangest thing you've seen so far?
The strangest thing I've seen so far. I mean, it's all relative as far as what you want to call strange. To me, none of it's strange. All of it is natural and awesome. Yes. It's nice seeing a bunch of other introverts just coming together and just being able to be themselves.
It really is where introverts become
extroverts. And an extrovert, exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
It's an extroverted world, you know? So
how would you describe DragonCon to someone who has no idea what the heck it is?
Just creative, outlandish, you gotta experience it for yourself. That's
exactly.
It.
So your favorite thing about it so far?
My favorite thing about it is seeing all the different adaptations and, you know, just
mashups.
All the creativity. Yeah, you know, they really are mashups.
Just
the different interpretations of costumes and characters. It's just
like a lightsaber with Mortal Kombat over here.
Exactly. it's really beautiful to see. You know?
Exactly. Well, thank you so much for doing that.
Thank
your
you.
Costume is lovely. Yes.
That wasn't as bad. You did not laugh nearly as much as I was being led to believe.
Oh, I just need to get that under control next time and just be more clear. But anyways, it worked out just fine. I don't have this one mixed yet, but I think one of the more fun ones I did was the one with the guy who played Riker. He looks just like Riker. He's an older guy, and he was in the first day, he was in a Riker full uniform. And the next day I actually interviewed him, he was in a Riker bathrobe. So he was just having a good old time. So that was DragonCon 2015. We're going to have a lot more of that, more than this on YouTube. You'll be able to see all the fun images and video we took of just B-roll of crazy stuff that was going on. It was a lot of fun. So,
all right. So now I'm going to quiz you about DragonCon.
Okay.
What was the highest quality costume that you saw?
Highest quality. God, it's hard to say because there were just so many people with like movie screen quality stuff. Like they're great. We went to a big Fallout shoot from the game and there's people with like full sets of like the mutant armor and everything. And they had distressed their costumes to make it look like they had been through battles and stuff. So maybe the Fallout costumes altogether was pretty cool.
Okay. What was the most creative costume that you saw?
Oh, one that I really appreciated was a woman was there, probably in her mid-40s, dressed as a fairy, not a very spectacular costume, but then she had two holsters, and in each holster was Febreze, and she was the Febreze fairy because people forget to take showers at conventions. And so I stopped and I shook her hand. I said, I thank you for your service.
You're doing a good work here.
Yes, you're helping us all. That was very creative.
What costume did you see that made you say, why the hell would anyone dress up like that?
Oh, God. I didn't see as many of those this year, luckily, because in years past, I've seen just tape. Like he was talking about, I saw that a lot. It was like two pieces of duct tape and like a cork, and that's all they got for a costume. Like, that's not a costume. That's not a character. That's just lazy. Why would you do
this
that?
This is not a strip club.
Exactly. If you're going to be something sexy, sure, but have a like a, at least a theme behind it or something.
But nothing that terrible this year. Just tape.
No, yeah, not really this year. And there probably was there, like I said, because 65,000 people were there. That was the new number this year. And there could have been any costume, but I can't remember offhand anything that was particularly atrocious.
Okay. You probably saw some drunken shenanigans. Did anyone get hurt or do anything extremely stupid?
Ooh, this is the first time I've been at DragonCon where I came out of the rave, or it's going into it. That's right. And I'm not too good with seeing other people's blood in a big way. Like if it's just a cut in your arm or something, I'm okay. But I'll get woozy if I see real life blood. And we're walking into the room where the giant rave is. And Patrick suddenly pulls me over. He's like, just walk with me. Walk me this way, Jarman, this way. And I briefly look to my right. There's a guy on the ground with security surrounding him. His head's on the ground and there's blood just flowing out of his head. And I
oh, dear Lord.
No idea what happened to him, if he was okay. We just kept walking because I would have like thrown up or something. But I hope the guy's okay. I hope everything worked out. But and people breaking bottles and, you know, falling over on things. And I had a couple guys I saw just sleeping on the sidewalk in costume, and Gnome was taking care of them. So both times I tried to like rouse them and then talk to them. And when I did, they were like, just leave me alone. I'm fine. So I'm like, well, fine. Screw you. I tried to help. So I tried
screw
to do my
you,
part.
Drunk Sonic the Hedgehog.
Exactly. Screw you, Fifth Doctor. I thought I liked the Fifth Doctor, but not anymore.
Well, good. It sounds like you had a lot of fun and a lot of nerd shenanigans took place.
Yes, indeed. It'll be even better when you're there next year.
That's true. So now it's time to lead into trailer reviews. Here to Play On Nerds, we have developed an interesting rating system to bring to you our ideas on the trailers we're about to review. At the low, low end of the scale, we have Burn It, where we think you should find every copy you can get your hands on and throw it into a barrel fire.
Kill it with fire. And our next step is Drunk Watch, which means that, yeah, I'd watch this movie. It'd be entertaining if I was under the influence of some kind of substance of some kind. But if I was sober, probably not going to check this thing out.
Nope, not going to see it. Next, we've got We'll See, which is maybe we just don't know enough about this movie to tell what the hell it's going to be.
Could be good, could be bad, not sure.
Eh.
And our next category would be Get the Couch Ready, which means I'm definitely going to check this movie out at home. Wouldn't necessarily pay the big bucks to see it in theaters, but I'm definitely going to watch it at home, so get that couch ready.
After that, we have Take a Look, where we are recommending for you, our viewers and listeners, to check out this movie and check out the trailer and tell us what you think about it. We wanted to see what you guys think.
It looks pretty good, but we're not quite sure yet.
Yeah, take a look.
Yeah.
Let us know.
And for our final and best category, we have Shut Up and Take My Money.
Shut up and take my money.
This looks so awesome. We're going to see it.
That's where we cannot wait to give Hollywood bigwigs all of the money that we have earned at work to go see a film for $47. We're so excited. We just have to go see it. We don't have a choice.
And that is our A Play On Nerds official copyrighted trademark system for rating our movie trailers. So Steven threw out these two trailers and I had not really heard of either of them. And I watched them both. And wow, we got some good ones this week.
Yeah, for once, I feel like we have two very high-quality trailers. So which one do you want to break out?
Well, I guess the order I saw them, I guess The Witch was the first one I watched. And I hope it's not worse than it looks. It looks fantastic, but this...
just awesome.
Yeah, it looks like it's the area, the time period of The Crucible and that kind same kind of thing. And like in Salem, Massachusetts kind of style with the... you know, the witch trials and everything, but doesn't explicitly say anything about witch trials, but it's more like a child going missing and they believe there's a witch to blame. And there's creepiest visuals I've seen in a long time. Really great cinematography, especially the sound design was creeping me out because I had, you know, nice headphones on and I could hear things that I felt were like in the room with me. It's very creepy.
What went we out into this wilderness to find? Leaving our country, kindred, our father's houses. For what? For the kingdom of God. Let us pray.
This family.
Very scary use of a goat.
Yeah. They managed to do that. Yes.
But it looks like it's going to be dark and subtle and high quality. They've got a couple actors from Game of Thrones I recognized.
Yeah.
In there. I just think overall.
I think it's the mom from The Eerie.
Creepy
as one of the actors.
It is.
Yeah.
But holy crap. If you haven't seen this trailer yet, take a look. I have not been this excited about a horror film or what I think is a horror film.
Oh, yeah.
In a very long time.
That last, those last few images in the trailer, I was like, what? That's creepy. Nope. Nightmares.
Yeah. But yeah, child goes missing. Boy running through the woods with a blunderbuss style gun.
A goat.
It's going to be great. A goat. Somebody being buried alive, I think. It's going to be a great, creepy movie.
Yeah, for me, I just put... get the couch ready, but if someone wants to see it in the theaters, I'll definitely go with them, but I'm not going to go alone because I'd be scared out of my mind. So,
I mean, I may give this a shut up and take my money simply because there are so few horror films that I actually want to go out and see.
That's true.
That being said, my wife is a little bit of a scaredy cat.
Oh,
so it depends. She's fine in most movies. If there's any gore, even blood, she just can't.
Oh, so she's more of a psychological scary movie, not a gory one.
Absolutely.
That's fine.
She's not a slasher fan.
Because she's a pleasant young lady.
Yep. I'm going to give it a shut up and take my money.
Shut up take my money.
It does look like that good.
So the next movie we're going to review is The Final Girls. Not to be confused with The Final Girl, which is a different film that just came out.
Really?
Yeah. It's got Final Girl. It's got Abigail Breslin, and she plays like a trained by a CIA operative to kill this group of boys who are serial killing girls.
Jeez. That's very different.
Yeah, it looks intense, but not that movie.
No.
Very different movie.
Completely.
From the one that we are talking about. So this movie seems to be a classic setup of a bunch of teens get together and go to a camp to have a good weekend. The twist is that through some odd events, they end up in a horror situation or horror movie that supposedly took place at this camp. And they end up as characters in this movie. And it's sort of them playing out the stereotype roles that they've been given or refusing to play out those roles and how that changes the standard camp horror story.
Camp Bloodbath is the granddaddy of all campsite slasher films. Max's mom plays Nancy, this shy girl next door.
Nice legs. What time they open?
It's cool you get to remember your mom this way.
At least I get to see her on the anniversary of her death, even if she is being chased by a psycho.
Guys, somebody's coming.
Hey, do you guys know the way to Camp Bluefinch?
Tina!
So, we're in the movie.
Oh, hi. What's your name?
Want to help me pick some strawberries?
Nope, but I'll give you a hand with those melons. Talking about her boobs.
Ew, writing is so bad.
What is that noise?
It's Billy. He's coming.
Everyone who has sex in this movie dies. It's awesome.
No sex.
Run! Wait. Selfie time.
Okay. You!
How do we get out of here?
Movies like this end when the final girl kills the bad guy and the credits roll.
That's all. That's the final girl. We just have to stay with her till the end of the movie.
Oops. I want no more than keep the hard work. I want chainsaws and big ass knives, and I want them now.
Guys, what's happening? Why am I colorblind? Am I having a stroke?
Or a flashback?
I wonder if all this blood is just corn syrup, you know? Like these characters are walking around with just corn syrup in their veins. No. Oh, God, that's blood.
I know in the movie you're supposed to die, but that doesn't mean you have to, right?
What do we do now? We fight.
What's happening? It's slow motion.
It's like a mix between Cabin in the Woods and Last Action Hero.
Yes, that's very, very astute.
Because what happens is that basically the lead character girl, her mother was in a real popular horror movie back in like the 70s, played by, I can't remember the actress's name, not Katherine Heigl, but someone better than that.
No. But, yes, accurate.
But you'll recognize her face. And then shortly after that movie was made, her mother passed away. They don't say how in the trailer. And so she didn't really get to know her mother growing up. And they're going to the camp that that movie is based off of. And they said, what better thing to do than see the movie about that camp before we go there? So something weird happens. Like someone comes into the theater to attack people. She finds the only way to escape. Or there's a fire. That's right. There's a fire in the theater. So she runs out with her friends through the theater screen, and when they all come to, they're suddenly in the movie, and she sees her mother there as a young person, but she's not her mom. She's the character she was playing in the movie. So it was all very interesting setup there. I really like that a lot.
Malin Ackerman,
that's her name.
Who we were trying to think
yeah
of.
She's a good actress.
Yep, it looks very like breaking the third wall sort of. It looks intriguing, and it doesn't look like it's going to be a straightforward horror film. And I appreciate that.
Yeah, great horror comedy. And it's got the guy from Silicon Valley, who I can't pronounce his name. The girl from American Horror Story, who from season 3, don't know her name. And the guy from Pitch Perfect and Workaholics. I don't know his name either. So there you go.
A lot of no-name people that you're going to recognize and go, oh, that guy.
Hey, that girl. Yeah, yeah.
But I think it looks great. And I'll once again give it a shut up and take my money, because I'm always looking for an actual horror film to go see in a theater.
Shut up and take my money.
Absolutely. And I think a good solid horror comedy is my absolute favorite. Like, and that's what this is. It's going to be great. So I think shut up and take my money as well.
Shut up and take my
see
money.
See you, folks.
All right. Two shut up and takes my money for the final girls.
Absolutely.
Take a look at the trailer and let us know what you think.
Not the final girl. We can't vouch for that one at all.
Not the final, not Final Girl with Abigail Breslin, which is a very different film, but the Final Girls. That's just unfortunate that they came out that close to
that is weird. They didn't check that out first.
Thank you for being a friend.
So we have someone to thank, and I can't remember where I know this name from. I feel like I know who this person is, but it's Darth Duck is the name this person's going by. It's our new iTunes review. And I feel so bad because I listen to about 10 podcasts on the regular, and I have as of yet to put reviews for them. And I feel so stupid that I haven't done that yet, because I'd love for more reviews for our podcast. So it's my goal in the next 2 weeks to go and review, give 5-star reviews to all the shows I listen to. some of you out there who are listening to this show know that I listen to your show. So I'm going to go do that this next couple of weeks. Before our next show, I'll do it. So if you guys can do that, that'd be great. This is Darth Duck. He said, no other podcast deserves a bigger audience than A Play on Nerds. Fun, insightful, informative, and very well produced in terms of both content and quality. You're missing out if you're not listening. And I think that's has to be somebody that knows us well, because that was way too nice. And
yeah, true. I mean, it could be a stranger, but not likely.
But that nickname sounds really familiar. Like I've know who that is, but I can't put a finger on it. But anyways, thank you, Darth Duck, whoever you are.
Thank you, Darth Duck. we are awesome, and we're glad that someone is recognizing it.
Exactly. So I'm going to go out there and give 5-star reviews to everybody. If you can give us a 5-star review, that'd be fantastic. It gets us higher up in the search rankings of iTunes so we can get more listeners and eventually make more content for you. So that'd be great.
We do you, you do us. It's just a big circle jerk of 5-star reviews.
Exactly.
Everyone ends up happy.
That's how circle jerks work, right? That's how that happens.
Yeah.
By the way, we're not a family-friendly podcast.
And in the end, we'll all be sticky and disappointed.
Sticky and disappointed.
That's right.
That's how the Greek Olympics used to end. Man. Yeah, that was good. Anyways. So that's our sweet show for this week. We'll be back in a good 2 weeks again to bring you more fabulous entertainment. We have some cool things on the horizon, some good shows.
Yeah. So join us again. Thanks again, Internet.
Stay nerdy, my friends, and keep an eye out on YouTube for all that DragonCon content. All right. Bye, everybody.